Yoel Falkowitz.
I'd like to speak about a topic that I think was addressed before, but the proper answer was not given. And I was here at a previous meeting, and I heard the superintendent so eloquently praise the school in Rishon. Very nice graphs of the successes and the graduation rates and all that. I was wondering, though, if the Hasidic schools were included in those statistics. Because I have a hunch that if you did, the numbers would be a lot lower. Because unfortunately, in the Hasidic school system, almost no education is given beyond grade third or fourth grade for older children. And the graduation rates are almost non-existent. Most subjects are not even taught, and that includes geography, music, science. All these studies are not even taught, not even touched. I'm not talking about failing grades, not teaching the subject at all. I grew up in the Hasidic community. I went to Hasidic school, so I know firsthand what the children get or don't get. They barely get anything. Okay? The children don't have a say in this. As we know, they're children. Their children deserve better. I've been on various news channels giving reports on this matter. I've spoken as a result to many parents, and the parents do want better education for their children. I've spoken to many parents, most of the parents I've spoken to. All of them say they want better education. The schools, unfortunately, won't provide it. It's up to the superintendent of the school to make sure that all children in the entire town get the proper education as mandated by New York State law. The law demands that equivalent education as to public schools should be provided to all children. So my question really is, if the law demands it, the children deserve better, we all know that. And I've seen you work very hard to make sure all the children in the public schools get proper education. The parents want it. So the question almost asks itself, who are you working for if not for the children? And why are those children being left out completely? And why is the question left unanswered so many times? I think anybody in power, anybody on the board who's not doing anything about it, should be held accountable. Thank you.